everyone! PGZ here with another night of Sunday Night Gaming! And this Sunday, I actually got a really awesome treat for you all! My brother's here to join us, and we're going to be playing Orcs Must Die. So, Mo, how about you say hi to everyone?
Hello!
There we go. He's my co-op video game buddy. We do... Honestly, like, when I started this whole thing, it was going to be a challenge for me because I built all these games in my library of games off of the co-op function to them. And then he went off and serving our country again, and I kind of lost my co-op buddy. So I was kind of lost for a while, but...
Damn him.
But now we got it back, so it's all right. And so we're going to play some Orcs Must Die 2. And this game is a fun co-op game. Like, it just rocks the co-op, and the main point of this is that you're killing orcs. Go figure. Orcs must die, kill orcs. Yeah. but your idea is that you build traps, and then the orcs come through the courses, and then you just beat them with the traps and the items that you have and different things like that. So what we're going to start off with is I'm just going to show you a brief overview of kind of how the menu works and how your character gets set up. And this goes by the spell book. So here you have the spell book. And this thing is all important. And it's got your vanities, which is skins that you can unlock. And since it's Halloween, we're going with the pumpkin head skin because it looks awesome. Plus, it's about Halloween. So why not? And then you have your trinkets. Now, trinkets are really cool. And they each give you a passive that it does and then an active ability that you can do. And you kind of can go into each one of these and you can upgrade them. Like you see, it requires 4 skulls to give this passive heal rate increase and 11 skulls to get the activate healing. You know, you can see that. And here's up here, you see the skulls. Those are basically your currency. And that's what you use to unlock everything in the game. You unlock trinkets, you unlock traps, you unlock upgrades. Everything is done by the skulls. So you have trinkets, then you have weapons, tons of variety of weapons in here. So it basically matches anything that you could think of. Like, what do you use, Mo?
I have no idea. I think I use a rocket launcher. I don't know.
Yeah, I think so. Yeah, because, you know, it's a good first flyer. So we helped each other out with that.
There you go. Yep.
Yeah. And I generally, I think, use the crossbow, but I just picked up the ice amulet. I upgraded a little bit. So I'm going to try that one out just to see what happens. And then here is your traps. And, you know, you can unlock each one additional one, and his inventory is going to be different than mine because we work with each other, and it helps if you actually do work with your partner because you guys can work off of each other. When you go in, you get to select certain traps. You know, he keeps up with the archers. That's your big thing, right?
Yeah, I think so. Yeah. Sounds about right.
Yeah, his archers just rock it, and they're just awesome and vital to every defense that we do. And then I'll do a couple little things, and all in all, we make an awesome death trap for them orcs. And then here's just basically what you have purchased and equipped. And honestly, none of us have played that long, so it's going to be a little bit of a learning curve for us.
Oh, yeah, it's been a while, too.
Yeah, it's been a while, definitely. You see here, we actually almost beat the game for the story mode, but we're not going to do that because we have no clue what we're doing. So we're gonna go a little bit lower difficulty here. All right, and it's really easy to get into a party in this game, too. And it's only 2 players, too, so if any of you people think you get more than that, it's only 2 people. So without further ado, we shall press the play button. And here we go. We're doing the chasm now. What's nice with these is all the pitfalls everywhere. You can just drop orcs off in there, and certain traps will do all your work for you. It's great. So great. And then I don't remember what the pathway is. Like, you have to keep in mind what your pathway is. Oh, space to continue. I suppose that'd be helpful if I was to, like, you know, pay attention. All right, okay. So in the beginning, you have your pre-built configuration that you typically do. But if you want to change anything, you press B. And B will bring up all the different traps that you can equip up and change out. So, like, I use the wind belt a lot. I forgot about that. I like that ability a lot. But you know what? We're going to just go with the ice one, because I'm curious about that. So you just unclick it, click on the other one. Let's see, got arrow wall, haymaker, spins and knocks around enemies. That might be useful. Spike traps, dart spitter.
I don't know what I'm doing.
I don't have a clue either. You know what we need, man? We need some things that knock people back. Like, what's this? Is the spike wall? There we go. How's your spike wall? Is it actually high level or is it pretty low level?
It's probably not. What's the spike wall?
All right, so we'll just, you know what? Do you have the spring traps? I don't know. I'll go with one of them. Let's see. We'll just,
Crap. How do you open your book again?
B for book. All right, I'm gonna...
Oh, I already played something, so I'm kind of booked into what I got.
All right, I will go with some... You know what, let's go with some spring traps. 780, yeah, they're a little bit cheaper. And by the way, this cost right here, below these traps, is how much resources it takes to actually build that trap. So you gotta consider that too, because you don't want to use up all your resources, like, on two or three traps, because that would just suck. Now, if you look at the little mini-map up there, looks like we have two paths that they'll eventually come down. I think they'll come out of this spot, and then they'll come out of this spot over here, and then we're supposed to protect the doorway, which is right over here. This is where we don't want them to go. And now, let me actually get some traps instead of just yabbing, huh? That might be
a little bit. That's right. That's right, Liz.
All right, I'll just leave that. I'm gonna put these over here. And I'm gonna leave you with that section over there for now.
You must be at least this tall.
Look at your mini map. It's gonna tell us which way they're coming.
Yeah, I know that's where they're starting right now. Eventually, they're gonna build up over here. So we're gonna go with. I'll set some spike traps over here, though. All right, where can I put them? I'll put them right here. You know what? I'm kind of regretting my choice to go with my freezing amulet instead of my wind amulet.
Aw, don't be like that.
All right, unleash the horde! And then the only thing with like the amulet I have here, though, I have a main account, and it uses it up, whereas the crossbow does not. Oh, I'm waiting for you to do something, sir.
Oh, whoops.
Time to dance.
Better remember how to play this game.
Yeah. I was thinking there's a zoom, but it doesn't appear like there's a zoom, so I'm just gonna just shoot away! Gosh, my accuracy is just amazing. By amazing, I mean absolutely horrible.
Uh-oh. It just lagged a bunch.
Oh,
my,
no.
My terrible internet connection.
Yeah, that hotel internet. You know how it's great. It's so amazing. Let's freeze some people. I can freeze you. That's cool. Freeze all you guys. All right, I'm starting to like this little ice thing. Oh, but then I'm out of mana, so yay, run away!
Perfect combination.
Should really almost make that into my channel name. Just call it Run Away, because I do that enough. I swear, I think every video I've done some form of running away.
That one's for you, old man.
It's a valid tactic.
Alright, now let's see. Let's put up some. Oh man, the spinner trap was dumb because there's no roof to put
it on.
Let's
roll!
I just made all kinds of rookie mistakes here. You would not think that we were awesome.
But we are, right?
Yeah, we are, of course.
That was awesome.
Oh, guys on fire. I still feel like I'm missing something with this, like, I think I should be able to zoom in or something, but maybe I'm just like completely wrong.
I don't remember the zoom function, but
I think it's only certain weapons that have it, but
all mine.
Die, orc.
Do the skulls add to your currency? Is that what's going on?
Oh no, we got one of the... So the skulls we'll get at the end. The currency is built up by how many people we kill and the money that they drop.
No, dude, I totally picked up one, swear.
Oh, did you?
Yeah.
Awesome. Hey, bonus skull. There's nothing wrong with that, right?
I guess.
Put another one of those. Put up another one of my spikes. You know what, though? With these little guys that are super fast, the ice spell is pretty useful, so I'll be happy with that. And the other thing is, like, with this, you can swap the direction of the cart if you want to. It's kind of cool. I don't think I did it that time, but hey, there's people coming up the other way. Because this I should pay attention to my side, shouldn't I? Oh, no. No!
What happened?
The edge of the cliff. I decided that I saw something shiny down there, so... Yeah.
Oh, that's good.
That was terrible.
Just investigating what's going on at the bottom. That's all.
Exactly. What are you doing? You fucking just pass. I'll pull that guy off. He's on fire. We'll pull you off too, buddy. Yay! All right, so we finished that round. So we get a certain amount of time in between these. Let's see, to build up until they send the next round in. And we get some actual bonus money, I believe. Let's not fall off the cliff again.
Traps are just so cool.
Indeed, they are. Kind of weird. Traps this are one, so cool.
This particular map, you can't really actually build a very good maze for them to go through.
Oh, yes, the mazes. Right. That's actually a pretty valid tactic that's worth noting. And some of these maps, you actually can use these barriers and kind of really direct people. Because they'll take the most open way. So if they you basically have a big giant maze set up that has no way to block them, they're gonna go through and walk through the whole thing, which means you have to do all the traps that you want. Fast things. Oh, I love the traps springing them off into the world. Oh, nope, nope. Oh, one almost got through. That was not good. I should probably be doing my job more and watching out for these little guys.
Another combo.
Yeah, those little guys, gotta watch out for
them.
So fast. Alright, go down. Yay! Headshot. And they're just going crazy over there.
Yeah, they're all feared. They got some amulet thing. Or potion or
something.
Oh, no. Help.
Oh, no, you don't. No. Ah! Woo! Good save.
This rocket launcher takes forever to reload.
Oh. Man. I'm running out of places for things.
This'll tickle a few toes.
Just load up the spikes. Final wave! There's so little traps over here. You're doing all the hard work, man. You're not letting the traps do the work. It's because you're just that awesome. That's gotta be it. It's those archers. It's done. And we got them coming up the other side. Alright. And also, just so y'all know, the traps won't actually hurt you. You're gonna be fine if you run into any of them. Oh. Fast ones. I think it was a good idea that we took the little bit lower level one there, Mo.
I'm still not particularly sure what happened my items do. I feel like that's something I should know by now, but...
Nah, that's part of the fun, right?
Right.
Gotta keep it adventurous. Oh, stop. There we go. And victory is ours! That was awesome, except we only did mediocre.
Yeah, skulls are skulls.
Yeah, that's true. Four skulls, I'll take that. So what you can do from here then is, I think if you press continue, it'll continue, and then it'll give you a moment in between, of course, to take care of those skulls and do something with them. So anyways, I think I'm going to actually cut this one short tonight. I think that showing the match, if we get into one more, some of these can actually take quite some time, and I don't want to hold you guys up forever on your Sunday night evening. Plus, we got some other video games to catch up on. Haven't been able to play video games with them for a while, so yay. We're going to go ahead and just do that. But anyways, I hope that you all enjoyed this video of Orcs Must Die 2. You can get off of Steam for... I have no clue. I'll have to put the price in the... in the link, I'll put the price in the bottom here in the description. So, yeah, I guess that's all. So I want to just thank you all for joining me, and especially...
It's $6.24. Blam.
Oh, there we go. Thank you. $6.24. Great. So I want to thank you all for joining me, especially Mo. Thank you for coming along on the Sunday Night Gaming, and I'm looking forward to... you know, once you get settled out and get in there a little bit more, to have you join me for more of these, because it's always a pleasure having you around. So.
Oh yeah, I'll be around.
Great. All right. So if you like what you saw, please hit that subscribe button if you want to keep seeing videos from me, and also hit that just smash that like button. And thank you all, and you all just have a wonderful, glorious Sunday night evening. Good night!